Hey guys and welcome. In this guide, we will be talking about everything you need to know to be ready for BFA Arena as a Feradrid. For this guide, we have worked with DJ Flappers, who is widely considered to be the absolute best Feral from the previous expansion Legion, being able to win the Ohio Cup and now qualifying for BlizzCon. This will be a huge guide, so I really recommend you skipping to the topics that interest you the most, or watch it in more settings and test out everything mentioned, before going on to the next topics. Alright, so enough of the intro, let's get right into it. We will be starting with going over the talents and possible specs you can play as a Feral. After that, we will take a look at what gear, stats and Azerite traits you will need to min-max your character for PvP. Keep in mind that this guide was written in the early stages of BFA and from the beta POV when it comes to 3v3. Some things might change during the next weeks, so make sure to stay updated with the latest hotfixes. So first, let's take a look at the talents you can choose from. As a Feral, you can play two different specs in PvP, the Big Bite spec or the Bleed spec. Both specs are really close when it comes to performance, but DJ Flappers prefers the Big Bite spec, not only because it is more fun for him to really one-shot people, but also because it can catch enemies off guard and create unexpected pressure that can lead to defensive CDs being overlapped or even dying without using them. Let's start with talking about the Big Bite spec, since it is a little more straightforward. The name already gives the hint, but the spec really revolves around being able to deal really huge crits with Ferocious Bite and focus on single target damage. For the spec to work, you will need to have three specific Azerite traits we will cover later in this guide. Now let's see what talents you will need. Lunar Inspiration is the pick here for most games. Alternatively, you could pick Bloodsend, which makes you a little bit more unflexible, but allows a higher chance of you dealing those big bites you want to get out. Now in the next row, Rail Charge is by far the best talent and has to be played 90% of the games. In really rare scenarios, Tiger Dash might be viable to kite melees, but this will almost never be the case. Notice that you have to sometimes play Renewal against comps like RMP that are able to one-shot you in a stun, where you will need Trinket Renewal to survive. In the next tier you should go Restoration Affinity, since the healing as of right now is out of the roof. Healing numbers are really high for Ferals, and you can top yourself with the spells you gain from Restoration Affinity. In games where you know you have a really hard time surviving and being tunneled, you could also alternatively pick Guardian Affinity to be more tanky. In the next tier, Mighty Bash is honestly the way to go. There's no other talent that comes close to it. Just a really nice stun to either utilize to get CC or to create kill opportunities. Tier 5 is what really makes the Big Bite spec. It is Incarnation. Incarnation is that big damage cooldown you want to use to burst your target down and combine it with every damage multiplier you have. For example, unused trinkets, racials, etc. Tier 6 only offers Sabertooth for Ferals. There is no other choice and it's just a really solid buff to your Ferocious Bite. It increases its damage by 20% and also makes it so your rip always refreshes if you use it, which gives you more time to actually spend combo points on Ferocious Bites. The last tier also doesn't leave you much choice. Blood Talents is by far the best and it's just great to get these big bites out, but also to pressure your enemy in the long run with good uptime on it. Notice that you should not be afraid to cast Regrowth in your enemy's face, even though it might feel a bit weird at the beginning. The damage will really make up for it. Now let's talk about the Bleed spec, aka the AoE pressure spec. Almost every talent choice that we just discussed stays the same in this build, but a few. This spec revolves around getting AoE pressure up. That means that you want to hit multiple targets and try to keep your bleeds up on as many targets as you can, at least two. The only tier that really changes is tier 5. Here you will not pick Incarnation anymore, but Soul of the Forest. This will ensure you that your rip will do more damage over time and that you get energy back more frequently to spend it on more dots. Also, tier 7 can be changed, but it is not recommended by DJ Flappers. If you are a beginner when it comes to playing Fairy Druid, you can play Moment of Clarity, so you don't have to deal with casting regrowths before applying your damage abilities. So now let's take a look at PvP talents. You probably already know, but with BFA you can now pick out of a pool of PvP talents and are not bound to tiers like with the PvE talents. The question is now, which PvP talents do we pick for each spec? Well, also here you have to be really careful on what to pick, since it will decide on how your playstyle will look like. Notice that the first tier only offers you trinket choices, but for ferals, no matter what spec you play, you always want to play trinket, since you are one of the more squishy melees and it can help you to get out of dangerous situations. Let's start with looking at the PvP talents you want to pick if you are playing the Big Bite spec. Ferocious Wound is always a super good talent when PvPing as a feral, especially with that Big Bite spec, where you are looking to one-shot with Ferocious Bite. Savage Momentum is really the enabler for the Big Bite spec, because it allows us to make sure we get the extra damage from Tiger's Fury ready for when we want to burst down the enemy. I will talk about why this is so important later in the guide. To round it up, you can either go for Thorns if you are facing a melee team, or Protector of the Grove if you really need to enhance these off-fields of yours. Both are utility abilities and don't have anything to do with how you play the spec really. For the Bleed spec, you want to play different talents to really spread that AoE pressure and make it as effective as you can. Rip and Tear should always be considered when trying to play the AoE spec, since it allows us to apply dots even faster. Savage Momentum can also be picked in the AoE build, because Rip actually snapshots the DPS based on your current stats. This means that if you use your Tiger's Fury and use your Rip with 5 combo points, it makes it do more damage over time than without Tiger's Fury. Ferocious Wound is also a go-to talent even for the AoE build, just because there are no better options damage-wise, and you still use Ferocious Bites to refresh your Rip due to Sabertooth. Again, you can sub one of the DPS talents for the utility abilities, Thorns or Protector of the Grove, if you know you will need it to survive against comps you struggle against. So all in all, quite similar PvP talents, but still slightly different. You should really pay attention of when to play more defensive with Thorns and Protector of the Grove, and when to really go for a full damage build. This comes with experience and nothing to worry about. Azerite traits take a huge part in BFA and are a replacement for the artifact traits we know from Legion. These traits can be obtained from certain items and will play a big role of how you play in PvP. As I already said in the beginning of the guide, the traits will decide if you can play a certain spec or not. To make the Big Bite spec work, you will need to get 3 pieces of Azerite gear that have the trait Raking Ferocity. Notice that you can't play the spec even if you have 2 pieces of that gear. It might even be worth picking up lower item level gear, just so you can get the traits to stack. For the Bleed spec, you have some more options. Keep in mind that all of these traits need to be stacked 3 times to make them effective. If you really can't get 3 of them, go for 2 of them, but always try to get 3. The best trait you can get for the Bleed spec is Dagger in the Back. Alternatively, you can go Filthy, Transfusion or Gushing Laceration. Stats and gear are really important in BFA, since there are no templates anymore. Especially with the 2 different specs, you will have different stat priorities, which is kind of annoying, since it also depends on what Azerite traits you have. So once you have enough traits for one of the specs, go for the stats you need for them. Other than that, keep every piece of gear you have, in case you have to swap specs. For the Big Bite spec, your priority is Haste, Crit, Mastery and Versatility. For the Bleed spec, the priority looks a little bit different. It is Haste, Mastery, Versatility and then Crit. So as you can see, it is just important to get Crit for the Big Ferocious Bites. For the Bleed spec, you don't really need Crit, so it just becomes a bad stat. So always look out for gear that gives you haste, since that is your first priority. After that, you either go for crit if you want to go for the Big Bite spec, or you just go for mastery and versatility for the Bleed spec. Furthermore, it is great to have an unused trinket for the big bite spec to make sure you have as many damage multipliers as you can. With BFA, there will be more races later on in the expansion for Druids. So when they come out, they might be better than the existing ones. For Alliance, you should definitely go Night Elf. Shadowmeld has great use in PvP, because it allows you as a Feral Druid to get a re-stealth. Also, it can be utilized to avoid damage or get away from dangerous situations. For Horde, the best race is Tauren. Not only the health increase is beneficial, but also the Tauren Stomp is superior to the Troll or High Mountain alternative on Horde side. Overall, Night Elf is the best race for Feral Druids though, but we might see some change in the future. Let's start with the big bite spec. The general gameplay is, as I already mentioned quite a bit, to deal these big bites to really one-shot enemies. What you want to do generally is to stick on one target and keep Rake, Moonfire and Rip on the target before you bite them. Notice that you do not want to multi-bleed your enemies, only if you really have nothing else to do, you should bleed different targets. Also keep in mind that it is not as hard to actually maintain the dots because due to Sabertooth, your bite refreshes your Rip, so you don't have to waste combo points on it. So how to burst? Once you have all your bleeds on the target, you want to make sure you have 5 combo points ready. Always make sure to be in that scenario before pulling the trigger. Now you want to make sure you have Tiger's Fury ready to combine it with your burst. You either wait for the CD to come up, or you Skull Bash someone and get its CD resetted due to Savage Momentum. Now if you have Incarnation ready, you should use it with Tiger's Fury and then also use your unused trinket if you have them and use Ferocious Bite to burst down your target. For the ideal opener, you should cast Regrowth first to get your blood talents up. After that, you stealth and rake your target. Then use your Moonfire until you get 5 combo points and then use Tiger's Fury and Rip to finish applying all your dots. Now get your combo points up with either Shred if you're in range or with Moonfire if you're out of range. Once you reach 5 combo points, kick a spell again with Skull Bash to get Tiger's Fury to burst with a fat bite. For the bleed spec, the general game plan is really similar, but the goal is, just instead of dealing big ferocious bites, to bleed at least 2 targets with all your dots, better 3. You will see yourself run around the arena way more to reach the enemies and apply your dots. What really makes this work is that you can refresh the rips on the targets with low combo point bites. This means you can just get the full duration of a rip back by using a 3 or 4 combo point bite on the target. The burst stays the same with the bleed spec, you don't really have any other option than bursting with Ferocious Bite. The difference is just that your bite won't hit as hard, aka your burst will be less powerful. Also with the opener it is pretty close. Make sure to, again, get your bleeds up and then land a kick if you don't have Tiger's Fury ready. Now if you play Night Elf, you melt and get a rake stun on an unbled enemy and Moonfire 5 times to get your rip on him as well. So that's going to be it for this one, guys. I hope you liked the guide and keep in mind that a lot of things I covered might change in the next few months, so stay updated with the latest Feral guides.